नमस्कार डियर स्टूडेंट्स, प्रिय टू माँ शारदा, वी आर अबाउट टू कंप्लीट अवर फर्स्ट लेसन दैट इज इलेक्ट्रिक चार्जेस एंड फील्ड्स फ्रॉम एनसीईआरटी टेक्स्ट। ओके, दिस इज प्रॉब्लम नंबर 20 ऑफ एक्सरसाइज, टेक्स्टुअल एक्सरसाइज। ओके, अ पॉइंट चार्ज कॉजेज एन इलेक्ट्रिक फ्लक्स ऑफ -1.0 इंटू 10^3 न्यूटन इंटू मीटर स्क्वायर पर कूलम to pass through a spherical Gaussian surface of 10.0 cm radius centered on the charge. Find flux if radius is double. Okay, now see, this is the figure. Okay, a sphere with radius 10.0 cm cube is at the center of the sphere. The flux is -1.0 into 10^3 newton into meter square per coulomb. Okay, here flux is negative. Okay, so obviously charge will be again negative. First of all, if we double the radius, what will happen? So see, according to Gauss's law, flux equals to sigma q upon epsilon on, here sigma q equals to q. Okay, so here also if I double the radius, okay, the q remains same, so flux remains same, so -1.0 into 10^3 Newton into meter square per coulomb. Now I have to find out charge, so flux equals to q upon epsilon naught, because sigma q equals to q, so q equals to flux into epsilon naught. Putting the values just, okay, -1.0 into 10^3, epsilon naught is 8.854 into 10^-12, so this will become -8.854 and 3 - 12, okay, that is 10^-9 coulomb, so answer is -8.854 nano coulomb, because this is called nano. Okay, in short, if charge is same, it doesn't matter what is the radius of the sphere, flux will remain same. Okay, now 1.21. okay, a conducting sphere of radius 10 cm has an unknown charge. If the electric field 20 cm from the center of the sphere is 1.5 into 10^3 newton per coulomb and points radially inward, okay, find the net charge on the sphere. See here, radius is given as 10 cm, but the point is at 20 cm, so it is outside. So here r is great, small r is greater than capital R. We know that for outside point, the sphere behaves like a point charge, okay, and that point charge we can consider at the center of the sphere. Okay, so E is given and we have to just find out Q. First of all, we will find magnitude of Q and then we give negative sign to it, because here they have given that it is radially inward. Okay, that's why. So first of all, we know that E equals to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q upon R square. So Q will be equal to E into 4 pi epsilon naught R square. Putting the values, E is 1.5 into 10^3. 4 pi 3.14, epsilon naught 8.854 into 10^-12, radius, it is distance, small r, or say distance from the center, okay, that is 20 cm, can be written as 0.2 meter, so 2 into 10^-1 square, it is small r, okay, the distance is small r. So it will become 667.23 into 10^3 -12, actually 3 plus minus 12 plus minus 2. Okay, now see, this will become 3 minus 14, that is 10^-11, and this product, okay, is 667.23. we can write 6.6723 into, we have two powers that we have to add in that 10^-11, so 10^-11 plus 2, that is 10^-9 coulomb, but it is negative. Okay, so we can write Q equals to -6.6723 nano coulomb. Okay, and the last is 1.19. Okay, that a point charge of 2 microcoulomb, okay, it is placed at the center of Q. Okay, here it is in charge. the size of the cube is 9.0 cm. Okay, and we have to find out the flux. Very easy. Okay, we know that according to Gauss's law, flux equals to sigma q upon epsilon naught, or say q upon epsilon naught. Q is given as 2 microcoulomb, 2.0, that is 2.0 into 10 raised to minus 6 coulomb. Okay, so I can write here 2.0 into 10 raised to minus 6 upon 8.854 into 10 raised to minus 12. Unit will be Newton per coulomb into meter square. Now 2 divided by 8.854, that will be equal to 0.22588 into 10 raised to minus 6 minus minus 12 Newton per coulomb into meter square. Can be written as 0.22588 into 10 raised to 6 Newton per coulomb into meter square. Writing in scientific method, okay, it will become 2.2588 into 10 raised to 5 Newton into meter square per coulomb. If we approximate, the value will be equal to 2.26 according to text into 10 raised to 5. Okay, Newton into meter square per coulomb. That is the answer. Okay, prepare well. Bye.